Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. I am Daini. So today we'll be discussing about the expected multiple choice questions with their explanations on coronary anatomy. So let's move to the topic. The first question is the artery supplying the anterior wall of the heart. Which is the artery supplying the anterior wall of the heart? So before going into the topic, you may need to know about the anatomy of coronary arteries. So the in this picture you can see this is the aorta, and the first branch that is arising from the aorta is the two coronary arteries above the semilunar valve of or aortic valve. The two coronary arteries arises, right coronary artery as well as left coronary artery, and the right coronary artery, it goes further and it divides into two. They are acute marginal artery, and the other branch that goes behind, that is the posterior descending artery. Posterior descending artery that goes to the posterior side and that descends down. Okay, so the left coronary artery, that is known as left main coronary artery, that divides into two: left anterior descending artery or LAD and left circumflex artery. Okay, this branch is the left circumflex artery. So the left anterior descending artery, this artery that supplies the left and right anterior part of the left and right ventricles, and it goes down. Okay, the left anterior descending artery has small branches. They are known as diagonal branch. Okay, and the left main, it divides into the other one, that is left circumflex, that goes to the left side and goes behind. Okay, so left circumflex, when it divides, that is known as obtuse marginal artery, and that goes behind. Okay, so the two arteries that arise from the aorta is left and right coronary artery, and the right coronary artery, it divides into marginal artery or acute marginal artery and posterior descending artery. And the left left main coronary artery, that divides into LAD or left anterior descending artery and left circumflex artery. And the left anterior descending artery, that supplies the anterior portion of both ventricles, and the left circumflex artery, that supplies the lateral part of the heart, left part of the heart. Okay, and the right coronary artery, that divides into acute marginal and posterior descending artery. The posterior descending artery, mainly, usually it is a part of right coronary artery in majority of the individuals, but in some cases the posterior descending artery, that is a part of left circumflex artery. So in that case, those individuals are known as dominant left coronary artery system. Okay, and in those individuals who in whom the posterior descending artery is arising from the right coronary artery, those individuals are known as right dominant individuals. Okay, and right coronary artery, it also gives small branches. They are sinus node branches and AV nodal branches. Okay, so this is about the arterial supply. In this is just a vague explanation, and then so the answer is left coronary artery. Next question: the coronary blood flow at rest is about how much? 250 ml per minute. With normal activity, around 65 to 75% of the arterial oxygen content in the blood is extracted by the myocardium, but in case of some activities, myocardium will need extra amount of blood, and when that is not met, in that case the heart may have ischemia followed by infarction. Okay, so in case of atherosclerosis in the arteries, the extra need will not be met. In that case, it can lead to myocardial infarction. Okay, and when we say about the blood supply, usually the blood is supplied to the tissues of the heart during diastole. During the diastole of the heart, blood is supplied to the coronary arteries, because during contraction it will not be properly supplied to the myocardium. During diastole, the coronary artery supplies the myocardium so that it gets proper blood supply. So now you have got an idea about right and left coronary arteries and their branches. Okay. So the next question is first branch of aorta. So that is coronary arteries. So the last question, which vessel or artery is known as the widowmaker? So the answer is left main coronary artery. Why? Because the main portion of the heart, that is the left ventricle, is the main part that contributes to the cardiac output. So the left portion, that is supplied by the left main coronary artery, that divides into left anterior descending artery and left circumflex artery. So that's why it is known as the widowmaker. In case left main coronary artery gets blocked, then the major portion of the ventricle that contributes in the contraction is affected, or they get infarcted and the supply is less. That's why it's known as the widowmaker. So just to recapitulate, the coronary arteries, there are two arteries, right and left, and the right coronary artery that divides into posterior descending and marginal artery, and they supplies the right atrium, right ventricle, inferior wall of the left ventricle, posterior wall of left ventricle, and posterior one-third of the interventricular septum. Okay, and the left coronary artery that divides into anterior descending and left circumflex. Okay, so the anterior descending, left anterior descending, the that supplies the anterior and part of the lateral surface of the left ventricle, anterior two-thirds of the interventricular septum. And the left circumflex artery, that supplies the left atrium and androlateral as well as posterolateral walls of the left ventricle, and as posterior wall of the left ventricle also. So this is about the circulation part of left and right coronary arteries. So for the hope you have got an idea about coronary circulation. So thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, kindly subscribe to my channel. The coming video may be on the expected questions from the rest of the part of coronary anatomy. Kindly share to your friends also. Stay tuned with me. Thank you so much.